Citizen King, an humble moment beyond belief. And I am so grateful for the other shepherds and the leaders of the people who have gathered here, who love and support and encourage and tell the story of Jesus. I count it an honor and a privilege to be among this gathering today. And as we gather today, I invite you to hear these words of Paul to the church at Philippi. Not that I've already obtained this, or I've already reached the goal, but I press on to make it my own, because Christ Jesus has made me his own. Beloved, I do not consider that I have made it my own, but this one thing I do, forgetting what lies behind and straining forward to what lies ahead. I press on toward the goal of the prize of the heavenly call of God in Christ Jesus. And let those of us then who are mature be of the same mind. And if you think differently about anything, this too God will reveal to you. Only let us hold fast to what we have obtained. And this is the word of God for the people of God. And let us pray. And now, Lord, we ask that you would open our hearts and our minds and our souls, so that we, your people, might receive your word with thanksgiving and with praise. And as always, O God, may the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be found acceptable in your sight, my Lord and my Redeemer. In the strong name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Friends, today I fall in line of a host of ordinary men and women who have made themselves available to the call of God in the words of a young saint. Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening. Or in the words of a young peasant girl from small town Nazareth, let it be to me according to your word. Today and throughout my life, I simply practice what Suwon Kidd called the spiritual discipline of availability. Daily standing before God as an empty vessel before a full fountain, saying, fill me, Lord, until I want more. And it is an availability that is rooted deeply in our Wesleyan tradition, and that is brilliantly articulated in the Wesley Covenant Service. Lord, make me what you will. I put myself fully into your hands. Put me to do. Put me to suffer. Let me be employed for you or laid aside for you. Let me be full. Let me be empty. Let me have all things. Let me have nothing. I freely and with a willing heart give all to your pleasure and your disposal. And so I invite you, and may I be so bold as to challenge both clergy and laity of the Kentucky and Redbird Missionary Conferences to practice a practical divinity, or the divinity that is so incarnational, that it not only touches the lives of people throughout mission, but it transforms lives spiritually. It is my prayer that in concrete ways our strategies are more than just pretty words on paper, but they make a real difference in our world and in our communities and for our children, feeding both body and soul. Through God's heart, I only make myself available as a bishop of the whole church, but in particular as a shepherd of Kentucky. I make myself available as a servant called to preach, a servant called to teach the truth of the gospel to all of God's children, to feed the hungry and clothe the naked and visit the sick. And I can only do these things if you, the people of Kentucky, will pray my strength in the Lord. For the world of darkness, pray my strength in the Lord, that I might proclaim Jesus as the light of the world, overcoming all darkness, and that in him there is no darkness at all. In a world of spiritual and physical hunger, pray my strength in the Lord, that I might proclaim Jesus Christ, who says that I am the bread of life, the same Jesus Christ who taught us to pray, give us, Lord, this day our daily bread. In a world where it appears that we are traveling in a dry and weary land where there is no water, pray my strength in the Lord, that I might proclaim Jesus Christ as the one who offers everlasting water and we will thirst no more. In a world where hatred, war, and division is running rampant, pray my strength in the Lord, that I might proclaim in word and deed the St. Francis prayer. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there's hatred, let me sow love. Where there's injury, pardon. Where there's doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. O divine Master, grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in the giving that we receive, and it is in the pardoning that we are pardoned, and in the dying that we are born to eternal life. Indeed, pray my strength in the Lord that I might do no harm and do good and say love to God. Pray my strength in the Lord that I might indeed guard faith and seek unity, exercising the discipline of the whole church, supervising and supporting the church's life work and mission throughout the world, calling all of God's people to live into the words of the prophet Michael when he says, he has told you, O one, what is good? What does the Lord require of you but to do justice, to love kindness, and to walk humbly with your God? Pray my strength in the Lord so that I might seek God's will over my own, that I might not do what is expedient or popular, but what is just and moral in God's eyes, believing that it is always right to do right. I make myself available to a movement that has at its center Jesus Christ, who stood in the temple and proclaimed, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim release to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor. When Jesus sat down after reading those words from the prophet Isaiah, he said, this day the word has been fulfilled in your ears. And friends, it will be fulfilled over and over again when in our hearts and in our minds and in our souls we make ourselves available to kingdom's work. And so I make myself available to the movement of God's Spirit that hands beginning to power to free us from the bondage of sin and death, the power to transform, the power to redeem, the power to heal, the power to reconcile us to God and one. And friends, I am not naive to think that this will be easy. But I hear the Apostle Paul say all things are possible to those who believe in Christ. Therefore, my brothers and sisters, I can think of no better time to be a part of God's kingdom. Yes, Charles Dickens' words may be true. It is the best of times. It is the worst of times. These may be the times that try the souls of men and women, but these are also the times to live and work and pray as if we were part of an unshakable kingdom. Martin Luther King Jr. in his last sermon before his untimely death tells a story of standing before God Almighty, and God asks him, Martin Luther King, if you could live in any area of history, what would it be? And Martin Luther King Jr. began to go down the narrative of history. He said, but I wouldn't stop there. If God would let allow me just to see the children of Israel when they crossed the Red Sea, I wouldn't stop there. And if God would let me see a young president in the bonds of war saying we have nothing to fear but fear itself, but I wouldn't stop there. He said, if I could live at that time when a president, when a nation was being torn apart, proclaimed the Emancipation Proclamation, Martin Luther King said, I wouldn't even stop it. He said, but if God would ask me if I could stop at any time, I would ask to live in the first half of the 20th century. And it was the century in which he was living. And he goes on to say, I know that that is a strange thing. Who wants to live in a world when the nation is sick? Who wants to live in a nation when there's darkness all around? But then he says, it is only when it is dark enough that you can see the stars. But to see the stars, my brothers and sisters, you have to let go of anxiety and fear and look up and know that God is God. I know we have major challenges in the church, but let's not grow weary in well-doing. Don't lose heart because there are too many souls that are hanging in the balance. Yes, there may be difficult days ahead of us. There may be rivers to cross. There may be valleys to endure and mountains to climb. But I believe that in Jesus Christ, we can offer as one writer puts it, a love that can never be found, a life that will never die, a peace that can never be understood, a joy that can never be overcome, a hope that can never be disappointed, a glory that can never fade, a strength that can never be diminished, a purity that can never be defiled, wisdom that can never be bound, and resources that can never be exhausted. I believe that our best years are not behind us. They are in front of us because one day Jesus marched up Calvary's Hill and gave his life, and we know the end of the story. We know that victory is ours. And it is in the strength of the grace of Jesus that I plant my whole heart and my mind and my soul. As I, with God's help, lead the Kentucky and Redbird Missionary Company, and I lead in the name of the Good Shepherd, who loves us all with an unconditional love, daring to call us the beloved, loving us with a love that has the power to transform us and our world. I commit myself to being the shepherd of the whole flock here in Kentucky, understanding that God so loved the world, not just part of it, but the whole world. And he loved it so much that he gave Jesus that all the creation might be redeemed and reconciled. I challenge each of you to remember who you are and whose you are. Remember that we have, by virtue of our baptism, and by the empowerment of the Holy Spirit, we have been called to a life of servant leadership together. Compassionate leadership that is willing to take a risk for the kingdom. Leadership that is willing to move beyond the walls and from behind the stained glass windows in our hospital. This is a beautiful and magnificent facility. But friends, I got news for you. This building is too small to hold the glory of God. This building is too small to hold the love and the justice and the peace that God wants to pour out on all Kentucky and all of God's people. Our community is looking for leaders willing to move beyond our comfort zones and build relationships across race, gender, and social status. Our world, our community, and our church are longing for authentic, Christ-centered spiritual relationship, and we have been called. We have been called into leadership that is constantly learning and welcoming accountability. Leadership that is unafraid to be rooted and grounded in Christ-centered spiritual accountability. I believe that God is still in the business of taking ordinary people and doing extraordinary things in and through them, especially when we dare to practice the spiritual discipline of availability, saying in the words of the Apostle Paul, "Not that I have already obtained this, already weeks ago, but I press on to make it my own, because Christ Jesus has made me his own. Beloved, I do not consider that I have made it my own, but this one thing I do, forgetting what lies behind, and straining forward to what lies ahead, I press on toward the goal of the prize of the heavenly call of God in Christ Jesus. And let those of us, then who are mature, be of the same mind. And if you think differently about anything, this too God will reveal to you. And so I invite you to press on with me, realizing again in the words of Martin Luther King Jr., not everybody can be famous, but everybody can be great, because greatness is determined by service. And you don't have to have a college degree to serve. You don't have to make your subject and verb agree to serve. You don't have to know about Plato or Aristotle to serve. You don't have to know Einstein's theory of relativity to serve. You don't have to know the second theory of thermodynamics and physics to serve. You only need a heart full of praise and a soul that is generated by love. And I've seen, and I felt that love in the people of Eastern Kentucky. In the high places of Eastern Kentucky, I found a simple grace, outstanding hospitality that I believe can melt the heart of God. So people of Eastern Kentucky, claim your unique giftedness to be bold in Christ. Reach people with your big heart. Again, all you need is a heart full of grace and a soul generated by love. I've seen it, and I felt it in witnessing two young African-American young men walking to church. We need the African-American church to be strong, especially in this day and this age. And so, friends, let me tell you this, that if I appear to be a little hard on you, it is because I believe that you have within you the DNA. Share the good news of the gospel somewhere inside of us, right in the middle of all the heartache and all of despair. Something in my spirit still tells me that God is able, more than able. And I've witnessed it. And I believe that God has a particular calling for all of us for such a time as this. Therefore, I challenge you to reach out into the depths of your soul and dance safe in your home. Lord, I'm available to you. Take my life. Let it be consecrated to you. Pray big. Dare to dream big. Believe and do big things for the kingdom of God. For it will be with this faith, and it will be with this commitment, that we will see the possibilities and live the promise. It will be with this faith that we will love, learn, and lead. It will be with this faith and with this commitment that even in the worst of times, we will continue to press forward. It will be with this faith and this commitment that we will forge together Christ-centered ministry action plans that lead to God's promise, fulfilled in the life and death and resurrection of Jesus Christ. It is with this faith, and it is with this commitment that we will put together spiritual blueprints for changing the world and becoming an unstoppable force in the world for good and God's justice. In the words of other voices, I ask you today, do you want to do something beautiful for God? This is your chance. Seals and Crofts has a song that said, we might not pass this way again. Today is the day to say, Lord, here I am. Take my hands, take my lips, take my heart, take all of me, and let them be used to your glory. Are you ready, Kentucky? Now is the time to tell the story of what God is doing in your midst. You, through the courageous and bold visionary leadership of Bishop Lindsay Davis, have set the mandate. Discover, develop, and send passionate spiritual leadership and resources to make disciples of Jesus Christ for the transformation of the world. Through the continued coaching and mentoring of Bishop Al Quinn, and I know this one, and I know that he is a great mentor, I know that he is a great leader of the church, and so now is the time. And I believe that God has and is and will continue to show us the possibility. Now, are you ready to move into the promise? Now is the time to make the vision plain. Now is the season to tell the story of what God is doing. Again, there comes a time when the kingdom must jump off the page and become living. Again, in the words of Mother Teresa, yesterday is gone. Tomorrow's not yet gone. We only have today. So let us begin. In closing, on my nightstand is a 107-page prayer book that Priscilla and I used. And it continues to be a source of strength to me. And it is entitled Prayers from the Heart by Richard J. Foster. And there's one prayer that no matter how many times I read it, it seems to jump off the page. And I share it with you now, and I hope it will become our prayer together as we begin our journey. It is entitled Prayer of Relinquishment. Today, O Lord, I yield my shelter. May your will be my delight today. May your way have perfect sway in me. May your love be the pattern of my life. I surrender to you my hopes, my dreams, my ambitions. Do with them what you will, when you will, as you will. I place into your loving care my family, my friends, my future. Care for them with the care that I can never give. I release into your hands my need to control, my craving for status, my fear of obscurity. Eradicate the evil, purify the good, and establish your kingdom on earth